Okay, here goes round two. Okay, so this is round two. I managed to ruin a piece of borosilicate glass and PEI plastic the first time around. The adhesive that came with the PEI is called 3M468MP, and it was supplied cut to size with a piece of plastic which I bought from eBay.
Isopropanol.
It has a jelly-like consistency, so it's quite easy to rip if you're not careful. It's also very tacky and will stick to almost anything, so once it's down, don't try and peel it off. PEI is also known as polyethermide. I've noticed it on Oyster card readers while going around the transport system in London. It has a distinctive greenish colour and is UV and heat resistant. From the reading I've done, this seems like the best stuff to use as a print bed, but I have to stick it onto a piece of 3mm borosilicate glass. Borosilicate is a thermal resistant glass, and notably the vessel for hot cups of Earl Grey drank by Captain Picard in Star Trek The Next Generation. It goes without saying, if you're going to build a replicator, you need borosilicate. Hot. It is also flat and will resist warping, unlike the aluminium heatbed. So a little earlier, I applied some isopropanol on a cloth to the surface of the glass to clean it before carefully applying the adhesive. A few centimeters at a time, using a clean metal painter scraper to push air bubbles out as I went along.
That's not bad.
I then cut the excess off, which left some little bits of adhesive on my blade and on the cutting mat. I peeled the protective layer off the PEI and cleaned that with some isopropanol. I then prepared to repeat the process. To help me line up the pieces, I used my engineer's straight edge as a starting line. This is about 6mm thick, so I had plenty of height to rest the PEI against it. Once the first section had stuck on, I got my painter scraper and used it again to pull out any air bubbles. So, some advice before trying to do something similar: avoid drinking too much coffee so your hands are not shaking. Do this while you're awake and not at the end of the day after you've been concentrating on lots of other things. Be patient, clean the surfaces before you join them. Use something like the straight edge to help you line up the pieces, and maybe don't work on a glass chopping board because everything was sliding around for me. If you want to watch my assembly and review of the Annette A8 3D printer, I'll link to that at the end of this video. And don't forget to check out other videos on my channel, which are CNC related at the moment. Thanks again for watching.